thing that we know.
Is Leslie Wexner have the house here?
Multiple hedge fund guys.
And, I think it is.
Of the New York Stock Exchange, which I can't mention, said to me, he was never known in Wall Street. He was never respected in Wall Street, and nobody even knew. He was an enigma. And so I think that is, that should be part of a new investigation. How, where and how did this man, who earned perhaps $100,000, $200,000 while he was at Bear Stearns, and then all of a sudden, the man is now worth, or estimated to be worth, $1 billion.
Well, I imagine that he will come under scrutiny for a whole lot of things now.
Yes.
But Conchita, since you got to know him, you said he was in your home,
yes,
you had dinners with him, do you have any insight at all into his
psyche?
I mean, what kind of a guy was he? Was it power? What was driving him psychologically, as far as you can tell?
Epstein, I know, he told me, came from Brooklyn. His father was a park ranger for the city of New York. His mother was a homekeeper, and he had a brother, and he has a brother and a sister. I think Epstein was a highly intelligent man, a curious man. He loves the arts. He was always, you know, from what I remember from our conversations prior to his arrest, he's a man who plays classical piano. He reads a great deal. He's very interested in science and quantum physics. He actually organizes big events for scientists in his island, in the United States Virgin Islands. And he's very interested in donating to artificial intelligence and other scientific research endeavors. And so I found him to be an interesting man, certainly a man who perhaps, as the French would say, was not very beyond un sapot, was not good in his skin. I think he had a need to be part of a society.
You know, a striver.
No, but not a striver. I think many of us are strivers in this country. I think he just needed to be part of society. He wanted to be accepted by the powerful, and thus the invitation to President Clinton on his plane. Why else would he invite a president? And I think the reason he wanted to be around politicians is because he knew that politicians needed him. What is it that politicians, all politicians, need the most? Money for their campaigns and for their re-election campaigns.
All right, so let's go back to 2005, 2006, when the investigations begin,
yes,
into Jeffrey Epstein. It begins by state authorities,
yes,
correct? The Palm Beach Police.
Well, the Palm Beach Police, yes.
Okay, and what do they learn? And I think you talked to the Palm Beach, former Palm Beach Police Chief at the time,
yes.
Leiter,
yes,
right?
Yes, correct, Michael.
Michael Leiter, who wanted this case pursued.
Yes, correct. So Chief of Police Michael Leiter, the first victim, curiously enough, the first victim who comes forward, because she is forced to come forward, is a Hispanic girl. And she was attending a school for special needs in West Palm Beach. And
oh my God.
She was forced by her stepmother to come forward to Michael Leiter. After that investigation, it unravels.
What did she say?
She said, the first victim, which I have her on camera in a Daily Beast interview in 2015, says that she was brought there by a girl named Haley Robson. Haley Robson was her neighbor, and Haley Robson was a principal procurer for Epstein. She, in fact, had been a victim, but she was 17 years old, according to Haley Robson's testimony. And when Haley came to service Epstein, Epstein asked her age, and she said, I'm 17, and he said, you're too old. And she also didn't allow Epstein to touch her. And so he said, I'm going to make a deal with you. And this is all in a deposition. And Haley Robson says that deal was she would bring Epstein underage girls, and the first girl she brought him was this girl whose name I not mention, let's just call her Jane Doe One. And so Jane Doe One was 14. She was attending a school for special needs, and according to her, she was a little quote shrimp, and she, you know, she was undeveloped. She was quite naive, quite
oh my God,
very innocent.
That's cute. Oh my God.
Years after I interviewed her. And she came to him, and he forced her to remove her clothing. He forced forced her to straddle him. He forced her, you know, into different sexual positions that she obviously did not expect. She was told by Haley Robson that she would only go into his bedroom and massage him. That was it. She didn't expect to see a man in his 50s at the time naked, and she certainly didn't expect to have to straddle him and touch him, do what he told her to do.
Now, you mentioned these recruiters, and a number of the stories mentioned this is the way Epstein did it. He had these women who went out and identified young girls who they could take back to Jeffrey Epstein's house or whatever.